I have had the somewhat rare DSAP skin condition for 40 years or so and have tried many treatments. Over about the last 10 years, I took pictures. I thought I would share here some of those pictures in chronological order. Perhaps someone besides me will find it interesting or of help in considering treatments or in developing treatments for this skin condition. The focus of the video is on one area of my leg for more ready comparison. So let me introduce you to my left leg in 2011. I had tried other field treatments by this time, including Retin-A, Efudex plus Retin-A, and Aldara, and of course it had liquid nitrogen attacks on some individual spots. This is the leg on treatment with Tazorac. The DSAP spots can be more clearly seen here in the middle of the Tazorac treatment before healing. They are more round than in later years. They tend to change with time, especially with sun exposure, which I have been avoiding. This is about 14 months after the Tazorac treatment. It looks not very different than before. You can see better here. At most, it looks like a few spots were lightened. At the time, I thought, however, that Tazorac did more than the other treatments I had done, but nothing great. By 2014, the lower part of the leg looked like this. Several spots were a bit inflamed. Since it was unclear if any of this or the other spots on the leg were actinic keratoses mixed in with the DSAP, we decided to try to remove actinic keratoses with a field treatment of 5-fluorouracil, Efudex. By the way, I was actually pointing just to have a size comparison with the finger, but keep in mind that spot. This is before fluorouracil. On the last day of fluorouracil treatment, and 10 months later. Slight detour. We decided to do a biopsy. Remember the spot I pointed to previously? Biopsy indicated squamous cell carcinoma. This is the electrocautery wound where the squamous cell carcinoma was burned out. The spot to the left of it got inflamed from the tape from the wound covering. Next up, duct tape. Yeah, that stuff you keep around to fix things. This was just a wacky idea I had. Unfortunately, this before picture is not very good, but you'll still see what happens. This shows the spots that I covered with duct tape. The big gray spot near my ankle is the electrocautery scar. I deliberately left some spots uncovered. This is what it looked like after 19 days of being covered full-time with duct tape. I just left the duct tape on until it fell off in a couple of days, and then gently cleaned the area and replaced with fresh duct tape. The lesion inside seemed to be turning into mush inside the raised rim boundary, but it didn't ooze liquid. The spot closest to the ankle was starting to hurt, but the others didn't. The spots that are not inflamed here had not been covered with duct tape. This is after some healing, and after healing about a year. Note the big spot above the scar. It is now only a shadow. This is one area of the many that were inflamed that may have decreased. I saw this more clearly on the treatment I did on my arm. This is the right arm before duct tape. Watch the spot with the arrow. Duct tape was placed over two large spots, including the spot with the arrow. After 17 days under the duct tape, the two spots are very red. After 5 months of healing, the spot that was marked with the arrow appears to be gone. And 2 years later, it looks still gone. To me, it seems like the duct tape really got rid of something here, but only one of the spots that got inflamed. It would be nice if it worked for all the spots. It is clearly the easiest and cheapest of all the procedures for just treating specific spots. You put on a piece of duct tape, leave it on, through showers, etc., until it falls off several days later. Then carefully clean and air dry the area and reapply more duct tape. It stays on unmoisturized legs longer than on arms. The intense reaction is a little scary to look at. Cleanliness seemed critical. I cut the duct tape so none of the patch I applied came from near the edges of the roll that might have been contaminated sitting on the shelf. Perhaps this technique would work better in combination with an appropriate treatment cream during healing. This duct tape experiment piqued my curiosity. It really surprised me how clearly the inflammation of the lesions stayed within the defined porokeratosis edges, and how completely it seemed to turn the center into mush without affecting the surrounding skin. There are lots of interesting questions. One, is this effect due to occlusion in general rather than something specific to duct tape? I guess probably yes, it is fairly general because I saw the same type of specific spot inflammation using just moisturizing lotion and plastic wrap. Two, why does one large spot totally disappear after activating with duct tape while a similar looking spot does not decrease even though both appear to inflame the same? It could be that the disappearing spot was something other than DSAP, perhaps actinic keratosis or squamous cell carcinoma. If so, maybe that would be interesting in itself for patients with a few individual spots of those types. The spots I've been showing pictures of have not been biopsied, although in the past I have had biopsies showing DSAP and actinic keratosis in addition to the one squamous cell carcinoma. 3. What is going on biochemically? I don't know. But changes in the skin with occlusion can include cytokine and keratinocyte activity changes. So it seems possibly related. Fluorouracil with calcipotriene is a relatively new treatment to remove actinic keratosis. As far as I know, it has not been studied for DSAP. It was said to reduce actinic keratosis 88% versus 26% in controls after twice daily application without occlusion for 4 days. I did this procedure 2 times, first for 7 days, then for 14 days. The research reference is below. This photo of my left leg is before the fluorouracil calcipotriene treatment. This next photo is 5 days after the end of the 7-day fluorouracil calcipotriene treatment. Note that the spot that seemed to be decreased after duct tape seems to activate much less strongly than the others. This is about 1 year after the end of the first fluorouracil calcipotriene treatment, before another trial of the same treatment for longer, for 2 weeks. I see no obvious difference from before treatment began. Here is the comparison on the same slide. I've drawn arrows to some of the spots for orientation. Here is the appearance at the end of the 2-week treatment of fluorouracil calcipotriene. Note the blob just above the squamous cell scar seems to no longer get inflamed, which is my criteria for considering it gone. At 10 months after the end of the two-week fluorouracil calcipotriene treatment, one other spot near the squamous cell scar is essentially gone, and the red spots further toward the knee are also gone. These are pointed out with arrows. Almost 2 years after the end of the treatment, the spot near the scar, which had been removed by the treatment, is still gone, but the small spots nearer the knee are starting to get rid again. Here is the comparison from before the first treatment to after the second treatment. A two-week treatment was shown to be more effective than 1 week on this leg, so some spots were removed, although again, only a few, and one came back. Again, it is possible that my spots are a mix of different types, and some actinic keratoses mixed in with a DSAP were removed by this treatment that has been shown to work with actinic keratoses. Maybe some were just deeper and bigger than others, and may be lessened with even longer treatment. Overall, promising. My arms worked better than the legs with the same length of treatment, but certainly not completely. See the video on my DSAP Skin YouTube channel called DSAP Arm Treatment with Fluorouracil and Calcipotriene. Legs seem to be way tougher to treat than arms. 2% lovastatin, 2% cholesterol, a new technique. This is the only procedure developed specifically for a porokeratosis such as DSAP. The choice of medications is related to a genetic difference of people with this condition. The research reference is below. This image shows before starting the lovastatin cholesterol treatment on my leg. Here is after 5 weeks of treatment with lovastatin cholesterol cream with no occlusion, followed by 3.5 weeks of treatment with occlusion 2 times daily, followed by 2 more weeks of treatment with sporadic occlusion. The redness of the spots may be fading, but it is hard to tell. This is the comparison of before lovastatin cholesterol to the 10.5 week trial I just described. At 1 month after the end of the lovastatin cholesterol treatment, the intense spots may have thinned out some from before treatment, but again, it is hard to tell. And at 8 months after the end of lovastatin cholesterol treatment, it seemed that there was no obvious difference from before treatment with the lovastatin cholesterol. When I treated the arm, it did seem smoother, however, at the conclusion of treatment. So what is the best technique? I think I'd have to conclude at this point none of the above, as is anyway. However, fluorouracil and calcipotriene with at least 2 week treatment caused at least one spot on the leg and a few on the arm to disappear, but many more did not, even though inflamed like the others. It is possible that this is a removal of some actinic keratosis mixed in with a DSAP, or that treatment needs to be longer. Duct tape alone caused one intense spot on the arm and some small bits to disappear, and may have contributed to disappear of larger spot on the leg, but many spots did not change, even though they all inflamed, and the reason for all this is unknown. My trial with lovastatin cholesterol cream may have showed some thinning of the spots, but results were unclear, not dramatic, and not long-lasting when the treatment was stopped. I am trying this treatment again, beginning with occlusion. It may be that even though no technique thus far has been wildly successful, I have seen partial resolution of a spot in one technique and further resolution of the same spot in another subsequent technique. And the leg I have treated most seems to have fewer spots when treated with an inflaming agent, except for in one area. So I may be keeping it knocked back with all these treatments.